Very pleasant day to one and all. So I am Dr. Guru Karthik Babu, Assistant Professor, EEE Department of Kamraj College of Engineering and Technology, Virudhunagar. So today we are going to have some discussion on the vacuum breakdown, and it is comes under the high voltage engineering course. First of all, what do you mean by vacuum? Vacuum is nothing but the pressure which is maintained at the value which is much below than the atmospheric pressure. And there we may come to the mind that the definition for the breakdown. Breakdown is nothing but the failure, or it is going to deteriorate from the original function. That's supposed to be the definition for the breakdown. So, vacuum may be classified under the various different categories, and it is going to be measured in terms of TORR, T-O-R-R. So, and that is by going to be mentioned in various parameters, and thus it is going to incorporate in the certain features here. So, that is in the range of 1 × 10⁻³, that is in the millitorr to the microtorr. Next we comes to the our cup of tea, and it is supposed to be vacuum breakdown. The vacuum breakdown may occur in 3 stages. It might be in the 3 mechanisms. First mechanism supposed to be particle exchange mechanism. Second supposed to be field emission mechanism, and third supposed to be clumps mechanism. First of all, what do you mean by particle exchange mechanism? So, in this particle exchange mechanism, the name itself have the meaning, the particle which is going to be in the exchangeable format, and there it's going to be emitted from one electrode to the another electrode, and it is going to impinge on the another electrode. So, that's supposed to be the main concept which is behind the particle exchange mechanism, and thereby the chain reaction may happens, and thus it is going to be the main cause for the breakdown. So, it is a pictorial representation for the particle exchange mechanism, and it is supposed to be cathode and anode. Thereby the particle which is going to impinge from the cathode to the anode, and it is going to mention in the various different forms of photons, electrons and secondary electrons. So, this is supposed to be the pictorial rotation for the particle exchange mechanism. So, the particle exchange mechanism is going to be accelerated from one node to the another, and that's supposed to be from cathode to the anode. The very simplest and the mathematical form of the net equation is going to be mentioned here as AB plus CD, and that is going to be the which is less than the range of 1, and that's supposed to be the breakdown may occurs. For followed by that, the Van de Graaff also proposed a certain other mechanism which is behind the particle exchange breakdown. The particle exchange mechanism which is going to be the main reason, and it is going to be the further breakdown cause for the entire thing. The mathematical equation which is going to depict here is AB plus EF, which is going to be the less over the range of 1. So, the particle exchange mechanism may be happens when it is going to be the unity for the certain elements, and that's supposed to be for aluminium, stainless steel and other features too. Field emission mechanism. So, second part of mechanism supposed to be field emission mechanism. So, in this field emission mechanism, that we may come to the mind that the sharp points on the cathode, which is going to be the main responsible for the breakdown, and thereby the existence of the pre-breakdown. So, here also the classification may happens in the 2 different way, and that's supposed to be anode mechanism, that's supposed to be anode heating mechanism, another supposed to be cathode heating mechanism. So, anode heating mechanism, here the name itself have the meaning. The anode is going to be in the very crucial format, and thereby the heating may happens in the anode side, and thereby the bombardment of the electron may happens, and thereby the temperature is going to be in the increasable format, and thereby it releases the gas. Then thereby the cathode is going to be on the reacher side, and thereby targeting the bombarding surfaces. And thus the process may happens, and breakdown may happens at the last. Anode heating mechanism and the pictorial representation is going to be depicted over here, and this is supposed to be the thing over now. So the anode is going to be the main responsible element here, and thereby the sharp point is going to be the main cause, and thereby the anode is getting in the vulnerable stage. Then by the cathode mechanism may happen. The cathode mechanism is the main reason for the next breakdown. So here the cathode may happens in the sharp points, and thereby the breakdown may happens. Third stage of mechanism supposed to be clumps mechanism. The name itself have the meaning. The particle may be happens in the form of clumsy manner, and thereby the breakdown mechanism happens. So here the loosely bounded particle, which is going to be in the clumsy form, and thereby the loosely bounded particle on the uppermost surface may be the vulnerable stage, and thereby which is going to be in the attacking stage. Subsequently, which is going to be detached from the mother electrode, and thereby the breakdown may happen. This bombardment may reach to the targeting electrode, and thereby the breakdown may happen. So the clump mechanism was proposed by Kreinberg, and the equation for the mathematical equation for representing the clump mechanism supposed to be V is equal to C dash. The clump mechanism may be happens in the parallel plate capacitors or parallel plate electrodes, and thereby the breakdown may happens in the mathematical format as V is equal to CD to the power of half. This is a pictorial notation for the clump mechanism. Here the loosely bounded particle may happens in the cathode side, and thereby the loosely bounded particle may be get detached from the mother electrode, and thereby which may reach to the anode, and thereby the conduction may happens. The conduction once happens means the breakdown may occurs, and this supposed to be the mechanism which is behaving. So it's supposed to be the second stage for this. The clumsy particle may be get detached from the cathode, and it is going to reach on the anode side. The mechanism happens here. The final most side here, the from the cathodic side, the anode, all the clumsy particles may reach on the anode side, and thus it is going to happen on the vaporization too. So the main theory behind the cathode clumsy mechanism for the was proposed by the Kreinberg, and it is going to be on the maximum of 0.6. The dependence of the V electrode material, which is going to be on the vice versa side of the anode and cathode. So far we discussed the three mechanisms here. So this is what about the discussion now. So thank you.